across it. It's awful. Hello. I am not very good at this. We're gonna see if I have any clue what I'm doing, and we're also gonna see if this is even recording its audio properly. So give me a minute to just stare at my phone for a second here. Okay, good, we are getting audio. Hooray, it's about to do feedback, which is oh so wonderful and annoying, but you know, it is what it is. I am gonna say, just let me know if I am, if the game audio needs to be louder or anything. I'm not particularly sure myself. We're not flying that today, I will tell you that for free. We will be flying the, one moment. I'm going to activate a webcam here. There we go. Cool. I'm gonna just try and check out or figure out my thing here. How do I chat? Is there a way for me? Oh, Jesus. No. Yeah. I don't know how to use my streaming software that well. I was gonna try and stick it underneath my camera, but I don't know how to do that. So, you're just gonna have the games offset to the side here, and the reasoning for that is because I can't just stream the game in widescreen like it shows up on my monitor, because this game likes to do double vision on the monitor when it's in VR, which is painful to look at. So you get the little box VR view thing, and then me in the side there. Hello. Yeah. So, today, I gotta clean my lenses here real quick. We will not be flying that plane there. So, No need to worry about swastikas on the side of our aircraft today. I'm gonna just click into the game here. We're just gonna do a quick mission, which is about to spaz out, because that's how this game do. I'm just gonna spawn here. I'm just gonna set myself to spawn here on the runway. And the game's gonna spaz out for a minute as it loads. That's very painful to look at, so I'm just going to point the camera at the ceiling. Right now I'm just gonna check to see if my skin that I made for this plane even worked. And then we're gonna do a little bit of flying around. And I might try and do a pilot campaign, but those don't tend to go anywhere for me, because I'm not particularly good at this game. My record is I made it 3 days in a pilot campaign. 3 days. And then I was captured. Because I got shot down. But, so, Hurricane Mark II setup. This is like my favorite plane in this game. She's not very fast, but she's very stable, and can have some pretty vicious guns. Unfortunately, she doesn't get that much ammo with her vicious guns. Also, we're going to strap bombs to it, because I want to blow something up. Set that to meters. We don't need a full fuel load, because we're literally just gonna go up, blow up a train or a boat or something, and then go home. Well, not go home, and then just land. 180 liters, that'll be enough. Custom skins. Oh my god, it worked. Hooray! Hell yeah. Basically, I just took like one of the default skins. Well, literally, this is how I do skin editing. I load up the skin, I click between the different camo options until I get one I like, and then I Photoshop. Well, I don't use Photoshop, I use GIMP. But then I just Photoshopped in some maple leaves with transparency behind them, because I am the most stereotypical Canuck on the planet. No photo. Oh god, what have I done? No photo in the cockpit, because I have a mod that makes it so the photos that are in the cockpit will actually be pilot's notes, which is very helpful. Except on the one plane I like, where they don't show up, it just gives me the photo, and I don't really need a photograph of some random woman I've never met before in my life on the inside of my plane. So we hit on pause, we hit center view, we throttle it down a bit. RPM, we want to be at 2600, well, we're not going to take off yet. So, open up the tanky. I feel like I'm off to the side for some reason, which is a bit strange, but alright. That looks amazing, having those on the side, although you can see how that's not exactly the nicest transition on there. There's a bit of a white border, but that's fine. So, this is the Hurricane Mark II, my favorite aircraft. It's a wonderful thing. There's our engine RPM. On and off on the gun sight, which we're going to leave on. I've got a mirror on there, which isn't the most aerodynamic way to attach that, and I feel like if it went too fast, that would just peel off or get dinged to the side. There's my radiator controls, which should be more open than that. Yeah, we want that to be at normal. That's the radiator indicator. That is the pipsqueak, which basically, if the needle is in the red, I'm pointed towards a friendly airbase, and they can then give me a heading towards hostiles, which is useful when you play on servers that don't give you the indicators. Also, indicators in this game, the way I have them set, a bit different from normal games. Normal games, blue is friendly, red is hostile. This game, blue is German, red is Russian. They might be wondering, why Russian? Because, you know, I'm flying a Canadian plane, quite clearly. but this game is, it's Battle of Stalingrad, or this map is Battle of Kuban, so it's, you know, that. So we've got the radiator is open. Trim, we want a bit of a nose up trim, because we've put a lot of extra weight on it. Flaps, I want a little bit of flaps, so that big red lever is my flaps control. I can lower them, I can raise them, and that's just neutral, so it's not being lowered or raised, it's just staying. And that is the flap indicator down there. We're going to go 20 degrees on the flaps. Temps are good. Oil temp is rated for 80, you don't want it any higher than that. Water temp is the rad temp, and you want that between 80 and 100. 125 is the max for when you're in combat. That is the manifold pressure, measured in pounds of boost, which I don't fucking know what that means. Airspeed indicator in miles per hour, because Britain hadn't heard of metric yet. Altimeter in, I believe, thousands of feet. Yes, thousands of feet. So the big needle is hundreds, the small needle is thousands, and I think there's an even smaller needle that's in tens of thousands. That is my direction indicator, that is my compass, in the worst spot for a compass. Down there is brake pressure, that is a turn and slip indicator, and that's your climb, that's your artificial horizon, that's a clock, oxygen supply, oxygen regulator, block boost, supercharger is that lever there, that is my throttle right there, that, I don't know what that is. That is pitch trim, and that is rudder trim. So this engine turns strongly to the left, although it looks like it's going to the right just because of reasons. So we give ourselves a full to the right yaw trim on the rudder, which will basically make it so that when the engine pulls us this way, the plane will pull us this way, and it'll hopefully straighten out, which makes taking off a little easier. We're going to set our engine RPM to maximum, and we're going to slowly throttle up. Oh, and engage the brake, which is that lever there. And you'll notice it's already pulling to the left, even though our trim is all the way to the right. Runway, get the wheel off the ground to lower our drag by a little bit, and once we reach about 100 RPM, or 100 miles per hour, Jesus, words are difficult when you're an idiot, now we're going to lower the RPM, close the canopy, raise the gear, lower RPM to our cruise, of 2600. There we go. And then throttle back to get to our cruise speed. And now we can level out our rudder, or straighten out our rudder, and then level out the pitch trim. There we go, and now we can fly level and straight. I don't know why those FPS numbers started showing up. I don't know how to get rid of those. But they're there. Over there, we have a train. Over there, we have some boats. And there's an armored convoy over there. I am going to quickly set my bombs to drop in a pair. Because if I drop one bomb, I'll have 500 kilograms weighing one wing down, and the other wing won't be weighed down, and the plane will do this. Which is not ideal. Not ideal at all. You'll also notice that this plane is incredibly fucking slow, because we're only going 130 miles per hour. Now 140. This thing is not fast, but it turns very well, and it's incredibly stable. Which is why I like it. It's a very good plane for when you don't know what the fuck you're doing, which I don't. It took me a disturbingly long amount of time to work out how to put those maple leaves on there. You can even see the original rondelle coming through there, which is fun. Anyways, I'm gonna blow up this train, because fuck it. Fuck this train in particular. It's a Nazi train, it's fine. I'm allowed to blow it up. Bombs away. Full speed to get thrown everywhere. And we got a good direct hit, and the locomotive is destroyed. Oh yeah. Now we can lower our pitch trim amount. Try and level us out a bit. Because we no longer need to be, well, pulling up all the time. Good hits on the train. We don't need to blow up the whole train, we just need to kill the locomotive, because then it's not going anywhere. I mean, they can just go on a new train to, you know, haul that other shit out, but it's... the locomotive's the expensive bit. So that's the bit that's important to destroy. I've got some targets over there, I don't know what they are, but we're gonna go strafe them, probably crash, and then do something else. And this is how I play this game. I get into the air, I blow up a train, I fly around for a little bit, I crash, I do something else. It's not particularly interesting. Normally there's a lot less talking too, but normally I'm also not on a live stream. Which is always an interesting thing. Oh yes, and I can also raise my flaps now. I don't know what that button just did. Oh right, I accidentally just turned on my formation lights. Did not need to do that, but I did. Press the wrong button. Oh, these are enemy artillery. Cool. Now there's one less of them. This is why I like the guns on this thing. You give it the You give it the cannons, and it's just a vicious thing, and I love it. Let's give her a little bit of nose down trim. Just so we can attempt to have it trimmed for level flight. I don't know what eye you're seeing out of, but when I'm... You're probably seeing out of the left eye right now. Yes, yes you are. No, that's the right eye. Okay, cool. We've only just reached 240 miles per hour. This thing's done fast. This isn't something you bring up where you're like, yeah, I want to chase somebody down. This is something where you bring up where you're like, I want to fly something that won't fight me. Because every other goddamn plane in this game, for the most part, will fight you. The 109, one of the easiest planes to learn in this game, will fight you on takeoff. The 190 will fight you on takeoff. Basically, every Russian plane will fight you just to, you know, work. The British planes aren't too bad to fly. The Spitfire can be a little bit of a pain, but it's alright once you've learned it. The Russian planes, with the exception of the IL-2, are all pretty much a pain in my arse. The I-16 isn't so bad, but the problem with the I-16 is, it's incredibly claustrophobic. The cockpit on that thing is tiny, and I feel like I have to suck my elbows in to be able to fly that plane. It's incredibly uncomfortable. Like, even though it's not real, and my arms aren't actually being crushed, I feel like they are, and that just makes it weird to fly, because VR is an interesting thing. Which sucks, because I love the I-16. Like, in flight, that thing handles beautifully. It's like a Russian Hurricane. It's a faster, climbs better, but more lightly armored Hurricane. I like that. Problem is, it is a pain in my arse to just not feel like I'm going to have to just be crushed on inside. I just don't like it. There's also the MiG, which is one of the nicest flying aircraft in the entire sim. Problem is, it will try to kill you at least twice every time you fly it. Once on takeoff, once on landing. Whereas the Hurricane is a nice and simple thing to land. Just had to pull those guys up because they were artillery next to my runway, which is never a nice thing. Now I know there's a convoy over here because I played this map more than anything in this entire game. Just because this is where I go when I just want to test something. Which is pretty much all I do because I still have no fucking clue what I'm doing 90% of the time. Oh, another thing you can do. You can also give this plane two machine guns and two 40mm cannons if you want to only do ground attack, because those machine guns will not scratch any planes. They're literally just there so that you can figure out where your guns are actually hitting before you fire off your 40mm, because the 40mm only have like 50 rounds of ammo each. They're destructive as hell. But they got no ammo. And they're very hard to hit aircraft with because of how slow they are. This is the ideal anti-air loadout, is using these guns. These 20mm cannons are vicious, but they've got like no ammo. It's like 90 rounds per gun. Not very much. It's enough, if you can aim. But if I've proved anything right now by missing stationary targets multiple times, I can't aim. There's a car down there. This is also like the only plane I can dogfight with. This and maybe the Spitfire. Well, the LA-5 I'm not bad with. The LA-5 is alright. It's very fast. Doesn't turn very well, but it turns better than anything else that's as fast as it is. It has two cannons on the nose, two 20 mils. with 170 rounds per gun, I think. So about as much ammo as this thing has, maybe a little bit less. Well, about 20 rounds less. I think I killed that car. I think that explosion killed the driver. We'll find out in a minute. Artillery is normally the reason. Oh, are they into war artillery? That's where they can't spawn. That makes sense. This is where rockets would be useful, is for attacking this convoy, but the problem is, if I want the rockets, I have to take the Russian guns, and they're not high explosive rockets, they're armor piercing, so they're really hard to aim, and I also don't like the Russian guns, because they run out of ammo really quickly. Those are trees! Oh, okay. Yeah, this plane's just, it's good fun to fly. I like it. The compass is in probably the worst spot possible, but, yeah, because, you know, I have to shove my face into my gun sight to see it, or look like that, and that's just uncomfortable. Just crunch my neck around. Oh, that was a hit. Hey, I killed a Ford. I killed an F-150! Or a G-917, whatever the fuck that is. Hang on, Ford, why are you selling the Hitler? God damn it, Henry. Actually, wait, no. I think Henry Ford... I think Henry Ford was actually, like, one of Hitler's idols. He had, like, a cardboard cutout of him in his office, like, for right now. That's an actual thing. God, can you imagine being in this convoy and just seeing an enemy plane flying this fucking close and just people blowing up? That'd be terrifying. Anyways, we're gonna jump out now. Oh, why is my engine damaged? What the fuck is it? You gotta be going slow enough, otherwise the guy won't jump out, but it'll still eject the canopy.
Alright, we have gotten out.
Yeah, that's how I land, I just jump out. No, I can do actual landings, I'm just not good at it. Well, I'm alright. I am alright. Okay, I killed the train, I killed two vehicles, I killed four heavy weapons. That's a successful flight in my opinion, if, you know, the plane made it home. That's not important, the plane doesn't need to make it home. Actually, wait a minute. There's a plane I want to attempt to fly, just because it seems kind of cool. It's not good at all, because it's this thing. So, funny story about this plane. It sucks. Historically, it just sucked. It was used because they needed aircraft, and they could make these things cheap. But then someone went, what if we put an engine that was actually powerful in it, and they made this thing, and it was amazing. But I want to try and fly the lag. I feel like the lag could be a fun thing to try and fly. So we're going to hit start. We're going to have a fucking stroke as the game tries to remember what's going on. There's a lovely loading screen on the monitor, but unfortunately in VR you get a seizure. And that's the best you get. Okay, so we have this plane. See, it's not a bad looking plane. I quite like how it looks, although it kind of looks like it's pregnant down there. Yeah, we don't need that much fuel. Did I install custom skins for this thing? I did! We installed a Swedish skin and a gray skin. We also have the official skins of factory made winter camo, where the engine got a little hot. Tricolor, white tail, yellow tail, standard gray, white, default paint scheme. Let's be Swedish. Because then I don't have the moral implications of working for Stalin. And I'm okay with that. Alright, we can equip 2 50 kilogram bombs, 2 100 kilogram bombs, 6 high explosive Ross 82 rockets. These are not high explosive, the game is lying. These are armor piercing, they have like no explosive range. You want the 132s for the high explosives. Aw, I can't equip rockets and bombs, that's annoying. Well, let's equip some rockets, because I've not used them on this thing yet. And, by default, you have a 20mm cannon and a 50 cal. That's not a lot of ammo. Let's equip a better, cannon, a 23mm instead of a 20mm, with high explosive rounds. That sounds good. And let's spawn this thing in and attempt to figure out how the fuck to fly it. Okay, well. First things first. Throttle down. Lower down properly. This thing has no boost. That's strange. Although, luckily, unlike the Yak, which is perhaps the most popular Soviet fighter in the game, the Yak has the fuel gauge on the wing. This thing has it right there. Much more useful. It also actually tells you how much fuel you have instead of just saying, hey, you're out, because the Yak's fuel gauge only tells you where you're at the very end. Okay, switch charge gear at 2,500 meters, which would be that lever. Okay. Do I have boost? I have no boost. Water is rated for 70 to 85, max 100. Oil is rated for 90 to 100, max 115. I believe the green is oil and red is water, but I don't see the water anywhere. Maybe it's just all in that one? I don't know. I don't read Russian! But we're gonna do what I always do, which is, the engine is spinning the other way, so we're going to go full trim to the left. And hope that I did that right. Little bit of back trim. Get us in the air. Do I have a flaps indicator? Oh, I do have a flaps indicator. Nice. What the fuck are you? I don't know what that thing is, but I do have a flaps indicator, which is wonderful. So we're gonna give it about 20 degrees of flaps. Okay, that is my, engine RPM, I do believe. Which, on Russian planes, you just set that shit to full send. Mixture is manual, oh god. I'm going to set mixture to 50%. That tends to be where it's automatic on these things. Differential brakes by rudder input and bombs drop one by one. However, I have rockets equipped. I'm going to set them to launch in pairs. Now we're going to throttle up. Yep, I was right. The engine pulls to the right. Now we're rolling. That's my speedometer there, I believe. Takeoff speed is 165 to 200 kilometers per hour. Ooh, fuck, she's pulling hard left now. That's annoying. Raise the flaps. wants to pull to the right, so we're going to give a bit of a left turn. I actually don't mind the cockpit on this thing. I have that machine gun, and I have a cannon. Let's go try and fire some rockets at that truck, and see if I have any clue what I'm doing. I forgot to open my radiators. Oh, radiators are fully open. Okay. I'm gonna go 30% on both radiators. That seems like a good place to be for a flight. I know that's where the MiG likes to be, but the MiG is a bitch to get off. To take off in. Fuck. I don't know how good the MiG is for jacking yourself off in. Yeah, to be honest. Alright, well, there's the train. I see my target. Let's go try and blow it the fuck up. Bringing back the fuel mixture. Okay, cool. So this thing is literally just set it to full throttle, set it to full RPM, and just go. That's not too bad. Cool. Now I only have one rocket launch left, though. Now let's try and kill this thing over here, whatever the fuck it is, with the rockets. Let's see what it is. Oh, it's a car. Hey, little car. Fuck you, little car. Oh, Jesus, I directly went. And here I was complaining about how fucking hard it was to use those things. Apparently, I know what I'm doing with this plane. Never flown it before, but apparently I have a clue. However, the temperature is getting very, very, very hot, and I do not like that. Kilometers per hour, so this thing isn't too fast either right now. However, I also have not done a single thing to actually. Let's try and use our cannon on this convoy up here. Well, apparently I destroyed more things on that train. Maybe they just caught fire and then had to blow up after, I don't know, because they told me about the train almost immediately. This is the MG. Ooh, I like this cannon. Liking this plane overall, it's not bad. It's very underpowered on its launcher, but it's decent to maneuver. That's the ground! We're alive! It's probably 60% on the radiators, or a little over 60. The trim on this thing is a little hard to figure out, but that's alright. It doesn't seem like too bad a plane. I don't hate it. I'm guessing that 50% is cruise, and then 100% mixture is combat. I'm guessing, I don't know. The only tutorial I've found on this thing just told you how to take off and land, and tell you how to fly for combat. And the guy that I watched to do combat tutorials hasn't done a video on this thing, probably because most of the community sees it as a piece of shit. That was a big miss. But I was also trying to force the shot, and that never works. don't know what role this plane is suited for. Probably none. A good guess is none of them. The MiG is the altitude, like the high altitude interceptor, which isn't a good thing because nobody really flies at high altitude in any of the times where the MiG is available and effective. The Yak is your general purpose fighter. I feel like this thing's just this thing's just what you take when you can't access the Yak, okay? Or if you just don't have to deal with the Yak, which is understandable. Okay, so that's the brake cover. That's the MG. That's the cannon. That's the bombs. I don't know what the rocket bomb is. What's the alternative? Ideal climb in this thing is at like 700 meters per minute. So about there-ish, I think. Maybe a little higher. Yeah, a little. Let's try and get this thing up to the altitude where you have to actually swap the supercharger, which is 2,500 meters. We are not even at 1,000 yet. The ideal climb is also at like 270 kilometers per hour, I think, but we're going a bit faster than that, so we can climb a bit faster. Oh, and you can also just fire all the guns at once. You don't have to. You don't have to do it one or the other. That's just me. I'm on board. I'm just climbing. Let's just, catch me ground! Spun out like a mad bastard, so let's just get out of that. Pen for free! No war crimes being committed today. Wow, I sound insane. I've got my phone up with the stream on it, just so that way I can, you know, monitor, make sure sound levels are good and all that. I sound insane. Well, for a first time flying that thing, didn't go too bad. It wasn't a combat mission, but, you know. LA-5, not that interesting. I have the Yak-7. What is the difference between the Yak-1 and the Yak-7? Well, I'm guessing the 7 is a lot newer. P-39, I wish you were good. I love this plane, but it sucks. P-40, not good, unless you're diving on a bomber. P-47, for killing tanks. P-51, if you think America actually knew how to design anything. I'm sorry, but when, like, 30% of your fuel capacity is don't use any maneuvers or you'll die, that's not good design. If you need range, put on drop tanks. My baby. Not a bad aircraft. Pretty good. Just vicious high altitude. Good ground strike. Actually worse somehow. I don't see how the 1942 is worse than the 1941, but it is. I don't understand how that happened. 1943 is probably the best one though, because it actually has a rear gunner. Yeah, you can put one on the 1942, but it makes it even worse, and that thing already kinda sucks. A-20B if you like bombing, PE-2 Series 35 if you like bombing, PE-2 Series 87 if you want a rear gunner and you like bombing. And then we have the German planes. There's a lot of 109s. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 109s. And then 1, 2, 3, 4 190s. One meatball launcher. It's Italian. 1, 2 110s. The Duck, the Stuka, the only jet in the game, also a terrifying thing when you're flying literally anything else and that thing fucking goes overhead. A bomber, a later bomber, and probably the best bomber in the game. Except maybe the A-20, I don't know. I've never flown this thing, let's give this thing a try. Let's see how this goes. Oh good, it loaded. That was surprisingly quickly. The MC-202 version 8. It's a very strange plane. It's also an OCD nightmare, because that wing, that right wing, or left wing, or whatever wing, yeah, it's the left wing, is longer than the right wing. Why is that? To counteract prop wash. Apparently it works. I don't think so. Also, its guns are all mounted centerline, so we can up our convergence to 400 meters. Armored windscreen. Yeah, sure. Why not? 2 7.7 wing-mounted machine guns, 2 20mm wing-mounted gun pods. I'll stick with just the 2 centerline 50 cals, thanks. Let's not strap some bombs to it, because I don't think this thing will fly well if we strap bombs to it. Lower the fuel amount, because we don't need that much. We have Mediterranean, German, someone. Prototype skin. Ooh, that looks cool. I like that. Allied capture. Or not allied capture, when Italy made up their mind about which side they wanted to be on. Do I have any modded skins for this thing? I do. I have a generic one. And I have factory camouflage with insignias. Which is basically just they didn't finish painting it yet. They're like, fuck it, just get the thing out there. Get it ready to go. Let's go with that skin. I kind of like it. Just basic. So we have three sites. We have that big one. We have a backup on that. Just like line your head up. Line your head up level with that thing. And then we've got the other backup. This cockpit is weird. Okay. Yeah, stop shouting at me, buddy. Shut up, please. No. Slow the fuck down. Slow the fuck down. Break. Wow, this cockpit was cramped. I feel like I have to move back a bit. Goddamn. Jesus, you'd have to be short to fit in this thing properly. The default view is way too fucking close. So we're going to move way to fuck in, press default view, and then lean back. That was maybe a bit too much. Lean forward, default view, lean back. Up a bit, default view, lean back. There we go, that's more comfortable. Okay, so that's my big brake button. Where's mixture control? Does this thing have mixture control? Mixture is automatic, okay, cool. Water and oil radiators are manual. Throttle level is inverted, so full forward is no throttle, full back is full throttle. Okay. I don't know what the fuck that big lever is. Do I have a flaps indicator somewhere? Yes, I do. Good. So that lever is flaps. I have no trim. I suppose because it did that weird thing with the wings, right? That would make sense. There we go. How's the canopy on this thing? Open canopy. Okay, it's right off to the side like that. Cool. I don't know what that lever is for. Actually, wait, that's probably for coolant. Okay, that's coolant. Good, that's one radiator. What's the other radiator?
Well, it's at about half.
Yes, cool. Okay, I got you.
I get you. I got no clue what half of this shit is. I'm guessing that's landing gear.
We're going to assume. We're going to assume.
I feel like I'm off to the side.
RPM 220 for nominal, 125 combat, 240, 125 atop, boosted 1.45 atop. Okay. Takeoff speed at 160 to 190 kilometers per hour. And that's a very large lever for the guns. Wow, this thing pulls hard from the left. Jesus. Yeah, the different wings doesn't really work when you're on the ground still, I gotta say.
Pressure has.
I have no clue where the fuck my manifold pressure is. What the fuck is it? There's my pressure. Okay, cool, I gotcha. Hey, they even have continuous and boosted mark. That's nice. Cockpit layout just because I can't figure out where the fucking thing is half the time. Well, let's try and find something. Oh, there's that little car from earlier. Let's go blow him up because I've got 50 cals. 50 cals will be the car. Hopefully. Although these are Italian 50 cals, so they're basically spaghetti noodles. They don't shoot quickly. And I don't think there's a single game that has them actually being, you know, effective. The car lived, too. I didn't even kill the car. I thought I killed it, but nope. I just hit a tree. Okay. Never flying that thing again. I paid extra for it. I'm never flying that again. Wow, that was painful. Painful flying that thing. Let's see if I can manage to do a takeoff in the 190. I like the 190. I do. It's a fun plane to fly. Takeoff is an ass. God damn, takeoff in this thing sucks. Okay, day. Fuckwolf 190A3. Do I have a skin that doesn't have a swastika on it? No. No, I do not. I should probably get one. Just a theory, but I should probably get one of those. So we have two machine guns in the wings, that's what those little bits poking out there are. And we have two 20mm cannon. We can also strap a 500-pound bomb to it, and we can put wing-mounted guns in. Strap a 500-pound bomb to it. Is it pound or is it kilogram? It's kilogram. Oh boy. We don't need a lot of fuel. And let's go. In theory, this thing should be easy to take off. It's powerful. The cockpit fucking sucks, Jesus. This thing's got a lot of power. It's got tow brakes, which makes steering nice and easy. It's got tow brakes, which should make that nice and easy. It's got really good rudder control, like rudder response. It's nice on that. And everything's automated in this thing, because it's a German fighter. Everything's automated. It's just how they were. Which is nice when you're trying to learn. Problem is, one, holy fuck, this is a tight cockpit, Jesus. Problem is, tail wheel rotates a lot. Also, this thing has no fucking trim. None. Okay, we've set flaps to take off. Am I supposed to be able to read that from in here? Jesus. We gotta pull back on the stick to keep our tail wheel locked so we don't accidentally fucking kill ourselves. Takeoff speed 170 to 210 kilometers per hour. Should not be hard to achieve. For a while, this was the fastest plane ever fucking seen. The worst takeoff I've ever done in my life. Nominal power is 1.2 atop, so it's 70 higher. We got 30 minutes of combo power, 3 minutes of emergency boost power, that's not a lot. the guns count as MGs, which is weird, because two of them are fucking cannons. Okay, no, those are the cannons on the outside. It's got the MGs mounted on the nose, I believe, because MG-17s are machine guns, and 151s are cannons. Weird. 151 means cannon 15mm, but then when they made the 20mm version, they went 151/20 because Germany can't decide on how to fucking do that. Seems that really poor fucking visibility.
They're being shot at, that's not nice.
Somebody does not like me down there. Probably the boat. Yes, the boats do not like me. Let's blow one of them up. I have a 500-kilogram bomb. And enough speed to drop it on your fucking head. Oh, I crashed into him. But I blew him up too, so that's fine. It's okay. I'm an excellent pilot. What are you talking about? Crashing into my target to kill it? No, I'm not Japanese. What are you talking about? I don't fly like I'm from fucking Imperial Japan. What are you on about? There's also the A5 variant, which is a little heavier. So it's not quite as fast, but it carries bigger guns, I believe. There's the A8, which is the same thing to a higher degree. And then there's the D9, which is, what if we put a bigger engine in the motherfucker? Anyways, let's try and do a pilot campaign. Or career. I don't fucking know. Words! Create a new career. Battle of Moscow. Let's go. Soviet Union. It's 1941, and the Germans have said, fuck you, Stalin. And that's really all you need to know about the about the start of the war. Let's fly MiGs. Yeah, they have I-16s. They have MiGs. They have I-16s. We're gonna fly MiGs. Because it's less terrifying inside the cockpit of that thing. Yeah, sure, that's a... Sure. Our name is Matvey Rybakov. That pronunciation was abysmal. But it's fine. $5.50. Still have a while to go until I have to go to work. About 2 hours. That's enough time to crash many more times. Okay, it is... Clear skies, temperatures 8 degrees Celsius, clouds are at 500 meters, east wind of 5 meters a second. Unit HQ, how many guys have we got? There's 11 of us, and we have 10 planes. Planning room. What are we doing? We're covering a river crossing. Okay. Okay. Fly some air cover. Gotcha. Start that mission. Let's go. Load the game. I seriously feel like I'm gonna have a fucking stroke every time the game loads like that. It is painful. Like, why couldn't you just flash up a flat image Look, show me what's on the monitor, for God's sakes. God, that's painful to look at. Yep, gotta clean the lenses again. Otherwise, it's blurry as fuck, and I can't see. Alright, so we will take off from here. Well, we'll take off from here, fly to here, head southeast down to the river. Why the hell are we crossing that river? The enemy is that way. Why are we crossing that river going that way? But okay. So we'll fly past the town of Zubtsov, or Zubtsov, word. That place. Cross the river at that town. We will head southeast down to this town of Bor and its river. So we're going to take off, we're going to fly southeast from the river, we're going to pass a runway, a town, cover a river crossing at another town, and then fly home. Cool. And this is my beautiful plane. Not sure why it's got that skin on it, but okay. Oh, it's equipped with gun pods under the wings. Fun. I would like only 50 cals, please. Just give me lots of 50 cals. So now I've got 50 cals on the wings and 50 cals on the nose. That'll be nice. Set convergence to 230. Fuel. Yeah, 300 liters sounds like enough. And I have a better skin that I like for this thing. It's the get the fucking thing in the air skin. As I like to call it. Hey, that's right. Automatic. This thing. You just worry about your mixtures. This thing is surprisingly good visibility. Like, it's remarkably good visibility. Basically, if we want boost power, we just full send the mixture max. This is a remarkably easy plane to fly while you're in the air. The problem is when it's not in the air. The problem with this thing is when it's on the ground. thing's boosted, it looks like it's on fire, which is a fun way to trick opponents if you're in a multiplayer server. Against AI, it doesn't work, but if you're in a multiplayer server, you can engage your boost to make it look like you're on fire. And if you're in a dive and you look like you're on fire, they might leave you alone. And then you can pull out and be like, haha, it's like, yeah, I'm alive, fuck you. And then because you were in a dive, this plane performs best at high altitudes, and you get slaughtered at low altitudes, you just die again. You just die anyways, because they're like, oh, okay. He's still alive, and now he's weak. King. Also, the nose on this thing is fucking massive, hard to see around. So there's the other town over there. Right? Yes, there's that other town right up there. And there's... Oh, wait, no, the town's right there. What the fuck is that over there? Oh, that's common mode. Okay, there's the town we're defending. And they bombed one of our bridges, so we built a temporary one, and we only have to defend it in case they decide they want to send more people. So we're just gonna fly air cover. Basically means I'm just gonna fly in a circle while the time scale is on max and just wait for the radio to go, hey, there's enemies. Oh, breathing system is apparently turned on. How high am I? Oh, I'm at about 3,000 meters. This thing does perform best at higher altitudes. This plane does not do well when it goes slow. You get this thing going slow, you're just gonna have a bad time. Does not turn well at low altitudes and or at low speeds, and it likes to stall. You want to keep this thing going fast, which is the exact opposite of what I'm good at. But until I can use my beloved Hurricane, we're going to use this thing, because the I-16 is not comfortable to fly. I dislike it. I dislike being inside it immensely. There are many things I like being inside. The I-16, not one of them. And yes, you were meant to take that out of context. I want to get up to a nice high altitude. This thing performed best at 5,000 meters, which is unfortunate, because, Russian doctrine at the time was low altitude maneuverable. This thing is high altitude fast. This thing would have done well over Western Europe, where the doctrine was high altitude. Not Eastern Europe, where the doctrine was, if you can touch the ground, you're not high enough. And that was about it. It's like, oh, you're high enough off the ground that you can't make out the whites of the eyes of the guys that are manning the AA guns shooting at you? You're too high. Over the wrong town. I'm supposed to be over there. Over that town. I really wish ground targets loaded in better? Because there's supposed to be a bridge there. Primary mission objective completed. Apparently we did our jobs. We're allowed to go home now. Apparently, the Germans did not feel like attacking us today. That's entertaining. So we're just allowed to go home now. That's the mission. We're done. So this thing has a climb. This thing has a climb indicator, a turn and bank, and slip indicator, and an artificial horizon. And then the lag had none of that. I think the lag had like a slip indicator and exit. Yeah, those rivers are definitely from a distance that day. I don't know about the importance of pulling or something there. I don't want to, my team has got a fucking mile away. I love how basic these early Russian artificial horizons are. It's just like a pin with a plane on it that just goes up and down and then side to side, like that's your indicator. It works, I just love how simplistic it looks. Anyways. Also, that weird thing there, that weird set of pins in a ring, that's your backup gun sight. Which isn't the most precise thing. The sight radius on it is shorter than on a pistol, which is a little pathetic. Okay, our landing speed we want to be at 135 to 145. I am significantly above that. Hey look, it's my boys. I'm catching up to them because I'm going at a ludicrous fucking speed. I mean, I've slowed way the fuck down now. But still. There's our airfield. So we're going to begin slowing down. Which I will be like easing back on the throttle. And up again. We want to be at like 200 kilometers per hour, and we're currently at nearly 5. I think if I just hit finish mission now, it'll be like, hey, you're good. Or maybe it'll be like, hey, fuck you, you died. We're about to find out. Mission accomplished, hooray. Thank fuck. That was 17 minutes of flight time to do fucking nothing. But now it's the next day. I've been awarded the Medal for Battle Merit. Enemy planes have been spotted crossing our front lines. Now they're going after the goddamn thing, goddammit. Am I in this mission? I am, hooray! Jesus, it's gonna take a while before I can get my hurricane. I need a few days of flight before I can. It is almost 3 in the afternoon for this mission. Joy of joy of joys. Okay. Yeah, it's still being annoying. Loading, loading. It's almost done loading, I hope. Yes, we're in. MIG setup. No, why have you done this? Stop doing this to me. Give me 50 cals. Only 50 cals. All the 50 cals. Really don't need that much fuel. Like, 300 liters. Really all I need. Okay, so we are going to take off. We're going to fly down southwest towards the town of Asuga, or Osuga, or however you pronounce that shit, and then fly southeast. I feel like it would be easier to just fly south first, but okay. And then we will fly over here, where the enemy attackers are coming, to bomb our artillery boys, and then we'll fly back up to Zubtsov, and then to Rzhev. Okay, and then land. Auto level is on, and it's a fucking weird thing. Wow, that's a lot of planes. Okay. Boys, why aren't we climbing? We're better at high altitude. Why aren't we climbing? We're going to die. The only reason I can see those planes from here is because I have the setting on that makes it easier to see them. And I play with a lot of assists just for spotting targets, just because I'm still new. Still can't tell the difference between a MiG and a Yak from a distance, or for that case, I can't tell the difference between a 109 and a Yak at a distance. Up close, and I actually get a look at them? Sure, when I'm far away and like all I see is a few pixels, not a clue. Those are bombers for sure. Probably Stukas, actually. Or, no, those are probably, Heinkel 111s. Or maybe they're just fighters with bomb strapped to them. Who knows? Basically just a circle going on underneath. It's size 16, let's see if it doesn't come down here. It's gonna try to climb up there with a bunch of fucking. However, he's gonna use the vertical again. What a bitch. He's got like three things chasing him, I'll leave him alone. There's the juicy target. Why, he's seven. Much less effective than the F4s. By much less effective, I mean they'll still kill me easily. Actually, I think it's just E7s being used for ground attack. I don't think there's actually any bombers. I think it's all just 109s. That one's on fire. And he's still trying to shoot somebody down. You're fucking committed, sir. It is admirable how committed that man is. He's on fire and he's still trying to get the target down. I don't think we're done. There's still bombs. There's still shit flying around. I don't think we're done here yet, game. I'm gonna be honest with you. I don't think so. Done by them too, I get the feel. Because I'm not lucky enough to have anything go right for me. I just thought to myself, I should check my six. frustrating because I really don't have anything I can do. This is why you gotta watch your six. Jesus is on me. I'm fucking kidding now. This guy's dying. Carcass is turning on me, that's not good. Carcass is turning on me, ow, that hurt.
That hit me.
Oh, Jesus, okay, we lost it. Halo, but oh, Jesus, we lost our whole. We didn't lose a wing, we lost our water.
Your aircraft is completely damaged. Yeah, no shit.
I noticed. Tonight, on Joe Doesn't Know How to Fly Aircraft. Yeah, I was captured. Cool. Delete that man. Failed to delete. What do you mean failed to delete? Delete it. That's fucking weird. Okay. Exit. Settings. I would like to know. Turn off full screen. Apparently MSAA helps that ship better. Landscape filter off. Horizon draw distance 70 kilometers. Accept and restart game. Hopefully, I'll have a bit better performance now, because apparently I was having performance issues. Who knew? Waiting for the game to load, game to load, game to load, waiting for the game to load, 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 load. Pilot career. Okay, good, it did delete. Just didn't want to tell me that. I'm just gonna delete all of these, because I don't fucking play them. I always end up just making a new one anyways. Moscow, Soviet Union. Give me last assault so I can fly the Hurricane. Alexander Borisov. He will be an educated pilot from the Ukraine. I don't care. So it's not going to be that thing, it's going to be my plane. Oh, it's only 3 days in this phase until counteroffensive. Nice. Okay, so there's 10 of us. We have 10 planes. Nice. Is it winter? It is. It's fucking December right now. Okay. So we have to worry about overcooling our engines. Escort attackers, escort bombers. Start the mission.
Ugh. I know I have disgusting habits. Okay, there. Okay, so we will be flying from. Oh, fuck, don't zoom out so far that I can't fucking scroll, Jesus. Yeah, so we will be taking off from here, flying all the way over to here, to Staroy, where they will be doing their ground attack, and then we will fly back and land. We cannot let them reach Moscow. Oh god, we have to use the 303s. I gotta use the shitty guns. Fuck. Feck, 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 fecking feck. No photo, because I don't get pilot's notes on this thing with a photo anyways. So we have 12 303 machine guns. Oh, we may as well just be scratching the paint on them. Fuck. Ground is. There's the ground.
see right now. I really expected that to just end with me slamming into the dirt, to be honest. Well, now to fly at the maximum speed this game will let me fly at. Until these slow motherfuckers, who are somehow slower than me, and I'm in the fucking hurricane, until these guys get to where they're going. Anybody seen any good movies recently? Why the fuck does auto level have me in a dive? Well, apparently it doesn't. What the fuck? Just trying to see if I can fuck with that a bit. Gonna watch somebody else's YouTube video while I wait. It's got Doom music over it. Gotten a bit ahead of everyone, but that's okay. I don't really care. get under this cloud layer. So I can maybe see what the fuck is going on around me. Mudabba, mudabba, holy fuck. I don't know where all this smoke is coming from. There. Wow. Little light for halfway there. How's our fuel? Not looking so good. This might have been one where I wanted to take all the fuel. Just what our attackers will be flying over. Oh, bro. Hey. How's the bar in Diamond City going there? What's the hold up here now? Speed up time again, see if anything fucking happens. Yet another mission where nothing's gonna fucking happen the whole time. Yeah, we're flying home now. something. I'm happy. Not really, but no. Kill the machine. I like how this is auto level, but it's pointing me at the fucking dirt. No, fuck this career. And try a different one. I don't want to fly fucking escort missions. I was gonna say I got captured, didn't it? Oh no, mission failed. Oh boy. I don't fucking care. Give me something better to do. I was gonna say that was a mission failed, even though, you know, we didn't lose a single plane. This game annoys me sometimes with the missions it gives me. Tim's rewards points? I really don't. Next day, what do we got? We didn't lose a single plane on that escort bomber's mission either. Is the game just forgetting to spawn enemies or some shit? Like, what the fuck? Escort bombers, ground support. Fuck me. Oh, somebody got damaged. And they didn't kill anything. Fucking hell. Now, December 4th, 1941. Okay, so we're gonna fly over to this artillery regiment here and provide air cover to them. Okay, cool. because sometimes I'll just blow right past them, giving it like max power that I can. And then other times they'll just completely pass me by. Auto level once again, deciding that level means a dive.
And now we play the waiting game, doo da, doo da. Now we play the waiting game, boo boo doo da dee.
Yeah, like now I'm just fucking massively outspeeding them for no reason. I have a feeling this game's AI is just set to, like, fly at this speed. Now we just wait for someone to show up. Once again, like I was in the MiG 3. Like, oh, this is the longest. This is like the best pilot campaign I've ever done, and it's been cancel mission. And this. Crane, copy. Why are you saying copy? What are you copying? Is there another flight coming in here or some shit? Like, what the fuck? Apparently, oh yeah, there's some guys over there. That's a MiG. That's some, a couple MiGs. Yeah, I was right. And now we'll fly in a circle over here for a little while. And the game, and then the game will say, "You did good," and I'll fucking hit flight end again. Oh, I just want something to fucking happen. I did one mission where it was like, "Yeah, go intercept bombers," and I was like, "Cool." And I had cannons and 50 cals then instead of just 8 303s, and it was exciting. And I got to fucking shoot down on 111. It was great. This is just boring. To quote Red Tails, a movie a lot of people didn't like, but I thoroughly enjoyed. War is hell. What we're doing, just boring as hell. Yeah, look, we got more MiGs. 5 Hurricanes and 3 MiGs. What are we even supporting here? The enemy is like fucking miles away. Hey, look, 7 o'clock. Hey, Google, cancel alarm. Objective completed. Return to base. Yep, finish the mission. Mission accomplished. Oh boy. 10 minutes of flying in a fucking circle. Oh, I've been awarded the Medal for Battle Merit. Oh boy, next day. We're on the counter-offensive now, boys. First time I've ever made it to another fucking phase, and it's the most boring as fuck shit I've done so far. I've not seen a single enemy. I've shot an MG-34. Escort attackers, ground support. Fucking hell. Well, we're on the flight back now. So we're gonna fly up to there. Back. How far is that? 86 kilometers. Okay, new phase. Still can't equip my fucking guns with anything good. I know it might seem like I'm doing nothing but bitching, but that's what I'm doing. To fly at high speed again, cause otherwise I'm gonna go fucking insane. Is there a reason that we're all flying the wrong fucking way, guys? It's like we're supposed to be going this way, fellers. If I didn't have the time sped up, this would be like an hour of just flying there. Which is a little bit fucking boring. Nope, stream over. I'm fucking tired of this.